Good morning, everybody. Welcome to our session about cybersecurity in the Netherlands. We are giving this presentation on behalf of the Invest in Holland network. That's the promotional network of the Netherlands. And we at Innovation Quarter are part of it. We represent the Rotterdam-The Hague region. We is me, Martijn van Hogenhuizen. Martin is easier if you're a native English speaker. And Philip Meijer. We're going to take this presentation. We're going to take turns. So I'm going to do a slide. Phil's going to do a slide. I'm going to do a slide, not to bore you too much. There's a lot of information. You don't have to take notes. It will be presented to you later, this presentation. So feel free to contact us afterwards during the Q&A or at any stage, any later stage, if you're in the Netherlands, you're always welcome. We're more than happy to help you.
Yes. Hello. My name is Philip. Here's our table of contents. We'll walk you through our presentation, addressing relevant topics regarding the Netherlands.
If you look at the strengths, there's quite a few that we think we are strong in. One of them is the strategic location. We're based in the Eurozone, of course, with the port next to the sea. And the international business climate and quality of life are also renowned. The labor force is highly skilled. We have quite some political and economic stability. And our superior logistics are often very good for companies to be part of the Netherlands and be part of Europe.
Our country is home to a fast-growing cybersecurity landscape. There's almost 700 firms with cybersecurity as a core business, and most of them are based on the left side of the country in our Rotterdam-The Hague area, right there on the map where it says 32%.
Yes, if we look at the subsectors and the Dutch expertise, of course, there's a lot, if you break it down, there's a lot of consultancy, of course, just like anywhere. But thanks to the strong industrial economy, we also have quite a few companies that are pretty good at the OT. And because there's so much internet everywhere, we'll get to that later. Of course, the network security is quite big in the Netherlands. And being an international ecosystem sector, pretty much cyber, anything you can find anywhere is also in the Netherlands. So, but I think these two are the main specific for the Dutch sector.
The Netherlands is considered to be the secure and digital gateway to Europe. We are basically one of the most connected countries worldwide with almost 300 data centers. We have the world's largest internet exchanges, such as the Amsterdam Internet Exchange. And most of us Dutch have internet broadband connections.
Yeah, also, if you look at the digital economy, we're ranking pretty good in the world digital competitiveness rankings from 2020, second, third, fourth, seventh. And I think we rank first with our above basic digital skills. And we're just quite in digital economy. That's, I think, the takeaway from this slide.
This slide basically shows that we are part of the European Union, and our country is based in mainland Europe, aligning with European standards such as the General Data Protection Regulation, the GDPR, the Network and Information Systems Security Act, the NISA, and also the Dutch Telecommunications Act.
Yep, and we try to collaborate within the cybersecurity ecosystem, and we like to refer to this as a triple helix or triple helix. Basically, businesses collaborate with knowledge institutions and government, and they try to strengthen each other's R&D and innovation, share knowledge, and with the educational skills or sometimes educating people from all groups simultaneously, there's a lot more understanding between the three sectors, if you will. And the triple helix is, I think, part of the success on why the Netherlands also has a vibrant cybersecurity system.
So our country has a strong IT labor force, counting more than 450,000 IT professionals. Many of them hold a bachelor's or a master's degree. And I guess in general, the Dutch government invests heavily in IT programs to stimulate and help grow our IT population to be ready for future, since the Netherlands is in a digital transitions right now. Of course, we're also part of the Schengen area, enabling you to find IT staff in the Netherlands. If you can't find them here in our country, you can find them anywhere else in Europe due to our free flow of people and goods. And if you can't find them in Europe, you can also get them over in 2 weeks, those IT people, with our highly skilled migrants procedure.
The Dutch cybersecurity talent, yeah, there's much research going on. I think that's a takeaway from this slide, 26 research groups. Many students are choosing an IT degree, pure cybersecurity degrees from 11 universities, about 1300 cybersecurity students, over 150 PhDs from all over the world studying in the Netherlands and trying to strengthen the knowledge in the field of cyber.
Here you see an overview of our top universities and their IT graduates. Our academic universities are focused on research and science, and our universities of applied science focus on applying science to practice, which is a subtle difference.
Yep, here are some of the universities that are specializing in cyber: Amsterdam, Leiden, Delft, Tilburg, Maastricht, Eindhoven, the Radboud University. Many of them. These are the academic ones.
Yeah, and then there's 9 universities of applied science offering cybersecurity studies throughout the Netherlands.
Research initiatives in the Netherlands. There's quite a few research initiatives that might be interesting for you guys as well. Of course, Amsterdam holds the financial sector of the Netherlands. All the big banks are there. And with the AMSEC, that brings together experts from a variety of disciplines to study the aspects of cybersecurity within the field of financials. The Hague, being the center of the government of the Netherlands, it holds the European Cybercrime Center, Europol, Eurojust, the European Network for Cybersecurity, but also the NCIA, the NATO's cyber agency. It also holds the Hague Security Delta. It has a campus, offices can reside there. A lot of the companies that we help into the Netherlands, they land there because the ecosystem is there. They have Cybersecurity Academy. We've got funds for security. TNO has a center for applied research. Maastricht, all the way down south, very close to Belgium and Germany, has the European Center on Privacy and Cybersecurity. It's more focused on the legal issues related to personal data protection and cybersecurity. And Enschede, coming from the technical university that they have there, great university. They also have the Digital Society Institute. It's the largest IT research institute of the Netherlands that connects security research with other disciplines, such as critical infrastructure, terrorism, or transport networks. And in Eindhoven, also a bit down south, there's a Dutch Institute for Technology, Safety, and Security. And they connect public and private parties to solve security issues throughout technological and societal innovations. For instance, they did in one of the bar streets, they did a camera and sound detection project. Very nice, very interesting. They have the Cyber Resilience Center with Brainport to support the high-tech manufacturing industry that is based down south mostly, the JEDS and BrainBlock. So quite some research in the Netherlands.
The Hague is known as the city of peace, justice, and security, but it's also home, just like Martijn just mentioned, to the seat of the national government. And it's the center of gravity for our Dutch security ecosystem, our cluster, which is called HSD, the Hague Security Delta. And within our cluster, you'll find international security organizations, security-related government agencies, security-related initiatives, but also many companies, which are shown on the next slide.
Here's an overview of the Dutch cybersecurity market landscape at Innovation Quarter. We spent quite some hours figuring this out. Nice to get a feel of the companies that are already here, and the companies that we are trying to attract to the Netherlands are not here yet, but they might be in the future. So if you would ever decide to set up in the Netherlands, we can definitely put your logo on this little map. Might be some familiar names here.
Yeah, this is a slide about sales. If you are looking to carry out sales activities here, there's many partnering opportunities with more than 350 potential partners, such as resellers, system integrators, distries, and MSSPs. You can also connect with IT companies and cyber companies which are already here and have a market share in either Netherlands or in other European countries. As Innovation Quarter, we have an overview, a list of these 350 potential partners. So if you're interested, we are able to share this list with you.
Yeah, here's a quote of a company that we actually invested in, Cybersprint. At Innovation Quarter, we try to attract companies to the Netherlands. We help companies with their business development here and there, and we invest in companies. And Cybersprint says that the Dutch banking sector is among the first in the world to digitalize its business and services, and therefore creating a new demand for a cybersecurity solution. Obviously, they're profiting from it. So a nice quote about the ecosystem, I think.
Yeah, there's a growing demand for cybersecurity technology. Billions and millions are spent on IT and cybersecurity. But at the same time, there are just too many cyber incidents, unfortunately, still. So what you see on this slide is that annually, the amount of cybersecurity companies grow in the Netherlands.
If you look at the cybersecurity crossovers, there's a couple of sectors in the Netherlands that are quite strong, and they all have their own security challenges. For instance, the finance sector, of course, worldwide is probably the most up-to-date sector that you can think of. I think we hold the world's sixth largest pension capital fund, the EEX, the European Share Trading Index, and a growing fintech community. A lot of that takes place in Amsterdam. If you look at water and energy, if you look at the Netherlands, 26% of the country is situated below sea level. There's a bit of a challenge there, and of course, these systems are being hooked up to the internet more and more, so a challenge in protecting those. High-tech systems and materials produces this sector a value, I think, about 140 billion per year, and there's quite a lot of investment in R&D. Now, cybersecurity has to come at an early stage in these things, so the OT and IoT systems are very important. Agri-food and horticulture, I think we're the second world's exporter of goods. A lot of stuff going on there. We need to protect that as well. And of course, life science and health. There's the European medicine agencies here. Many of the big pharma companies are also situated in the Netherlands. And last but not least, maritime and logistics. We've got the number one port of the Europe. We used to be of the world, but right now it's of Europe because the Chinese started building, of course, and it's highly automated. So many cyber attacks happen on a daily basis. We need to protect our maritime and logistics.
Yeah. And should you have a unique proposition with your company, perhaps coming from Northern Ireland, it might be quite relevant to these sectors that Martin has just mentioned. Maybe they could use your solutions or your products. Also interesting is this overview of the many government agencies and international organizations that we have here in the Netherlands. Many of these organizations are located in The Hague City.
Taxation, most exciting part of the presentation, maybe. If you look at the Netherlands, we're not doing bad. UK is doing better, according to this slide, but we're doing pretty decent. If you want, we can inform you a bit more in depth. For now, just know that we're on top of our game.
Yeah. The Netherlands has quite a decent tax system in place. For instance, the corporate income tax for profits up to 395k is 15%, and it's 25.8% for any profits beyond that 395k. Also, to avoid double taxation in the Netherlands, we have many tax treaties in place with other countries, around 100 of them. And then there's the various tax exemptions, such as the 30% ruling, the WBSO, and the innovation box, which are all focusing on lowering your tax burden.
Business climate, excellent country for doing business. Many rankings in the top one by INSEAD, the World Economic Forum. Also a couple of number twos, three, fours, fives. So I think if you look at the Netherlands, the talent, the connectedness, it's all there.
Looking at this slide, perhaps it comes as no surprise that many companies choose the Netherlands as their ultimate destination for business. In 2020 alone, more than 300 foreign companies chose to locate or expand into the Netherlands. And they were together creating 8,600 jobs. And investing a smashing 1.9 billion euro into our economy.
Quality of life, pretty high in the Netherlands. A lot of the clients that we work with that are actually relocating to the Netherlands, they love it. And even when they're jobs end in a way they sometimes like to find jobs within the Netherlands because they like the quality of life so much. According to this ranking, it's from 2021, from last year, we're third in the world. So we're very happy with that. It's a safe country. It's a beautiful country. It's a flat country. You can bike everywhere. Yeah, it's good.
Four Dutch cities rank in the top 20 most livable locations for European expats. As you can see here in the graphic, the Dutch cities are The Hague, Eindhoven, Amsterdam, and Rotterdam. I myself live in The Hague. I'm really happy about it. And I guess Martijn is also very happy living in Rotterdam.
Yeah, it's not fair to you guys are third and we're 12th, if you ask me. But no, in all honesty, The Hague has a bit more of that cosmopolitan vibe with all the embassies and everything. Happiness levels across the globe, fifth in the world. There's a couple of Nordic countries and Switzerland that beats us for some reason. Don't know why. They've never asked me how happy I am, I think, but it's just, I think it conveys the message that the Netherlands is a safe, good, and nice country to live in. And that's a takeaway from this slide.
Here's a quote from Sectra, which is basically a Swedish company, and they leverage our Dutch culture to position themselves internationally. As the quote explains here, the Dutch opinion matters and is respected globally.
Doing business in the Netherlands, a little bit about the Dutch culture now. What are typical Dutch characteristics? You could say in general, every person is unique, of course, but in general, you could say that the Dutch are quite direct, they're opinionated, happy, hence the happiest country in the world, well, fifth, but still. Realistic, punctual, and cheap. Oh, wow, we're cheap, yeah. Well, yeah, maybe. The hierarchy in Dutch business culture, egalitarianism and openness. We have horizontal structures. Our executive only displays power when it's really necessary. And basically, the boss is part of the group. Employees take a lot of initiative. And in my experience, they ask why. Like, for instance, if I tell anybody from my team, could you do this or that? I love it when they say, why? Why what's the need? Where's the urgency? And I think that makes them responsible. And yeah, the Dutch business strategy and planning, I think it's cautious and pragmatic, step by step. And we're no experts as managers, but rather problem solvers or facilitators. And the business decisions, most business decisions are made on the basis of consensus. And suggestions from all workers are welcome. Reaching decisions sometimes might be time consuming, but I think the implementation is usually quite fast and efficient.
Yeah, looking at meetings in the Netherlands, usually we have informal meetings, but they are held on fixed times. And we use protocols and agendas. They are usually part of our meetings. Everyone is expected to make a contribution, regardless of their position. And it's really important to come prepared to a meeting. It has to do with time efficiency, and that's important to the Dutch. Foreigners, when we meet them, they often perceive Dutch meetings as a bit ineffective. But on the other hand, the Dutch try to make sure that everyone is heard. Negotiations in Dutch business culture. We like to get right down to business and proceed at a rapid pace. We can be seen as tough and persistent negotiators. However, we really value honesty and reliability. Time perception and keeping appointments. Yeah, to us, time is money. So we prefer not too much small talk. We have structured agendas, and not only in business, but also in social life. A 5 to 10 minute flexibility window is permitted. If you go further or beyond that 10 minute time window, you could be considered as perhaps unreliable. Wining and dining, and this is interesting. Lunch is a necessity, not so much a social event. We eat sandwiches everywhere, behind the computer, during meetings, even while having a walk outside. And if you have dinner with the Dutch, obviously we do have some small talk, but we prefer to keep business as our main topic. And if you would like to discuss topics outside of the business conversation, you could go into your home country, cultural events, sports, families, and also even hobbies.
We at the Invest in Holland Network, we can roll out the orange carpet, as we call it, for you. Invest in Holland is a national network of the Netherlands Foreign Investment Agency, and Innovation Quarters, a regional development corporation, is part of it. FDI, foreign direct investment, is the name of the game. We're here to support you. We're your friends on the ground, basically. We can connect you with local networks, the regulators, with the clusters, the consultants if needed. We are more than happy to organize a fact-finding trip for you. We can even do it digital in these days, of course. But we'd love for you to come over and we can show you around the premises that we have at offer, meet some interesting people. We can inform you about the incentives, the business locations, all the regulations and procedures that are in place. We've got the networks of people who know in depth about taxation, for instance, or can guide you with visas if needed, if you're attracting maybe talent from Brazil or India or whatever. And we provide you with free support. And of course, we're confidential. So that's our offering.
Yeah, and this is us, Martijn van Hogehuizen and Philip Meijer. We're here to answer your questions during the Q&A. And should you be interested to learn more, we can also organize a separate meeting. So thanks for attending our session. And let's stay in touch.